got the dignity of get lost.
Portland, Oregon. This is the story of Jim Spagg and Ed Dakota. They were next door neighbors for 4 years, and they got along fine until one of them crossed the line.
You know what I'm gonna hit you?
When I first met him,
I really wasn't crazy about him, but I managed to get along with him.
Well, we were friends. Ed and I were friends. I can't say I liked him, but I was his friend. The big difference between Ed and I is that I am in good, sound mental health.
Yowza, bowza, wowza, holy cowza, man!
He had his access show at that time.
But there are lots of people who really like the show, you see?
I was doing this public access show, which is quite controversial.
And we're going to try and have a band that will play in the nude.
He took off his clothes and danced. He did this on camera, and he put it on his access show, and he got away with it.
Man meets a woman right now, and I'm a good guy to know.
One of the things I had hoped for was that women would see me on television and want to meet me, you know, just like a rock star, you see?
If you want to meet a really cool guy who is me, Spag of Spagsville, give me a jingle now, you hear? Happy doodles!
Jim's efforts paid off, and he got himself a girlfriend.
She's the kind of girl I've always wanted, but never deserved. Wowza, 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 holy cowza, man!
It was a wonderful relationship. We got as personal as you can get. She would come to my house, and old Ed would offer her a cup of coffee.
Well, I guess we got to be pretty well acquainted.
That's off limits, because he's my neighbor, right?
It just happened, man.
And he got her pregnant. They had twins.
We knew that we were going to have conflict. He'd be probably not happy, you know? If I was in his position, I would not be happy.
You broke into my relationship, you selfish son of a...
I wanted him to be as miserable as I was, because I was really miserable. So every time he would come out, I'd come out there and I'd call him every name I could.
You dumb bastard.
I mean, I just razzed the hell out of him.
Damn feral dog.
Which, I was in my yard, and I was expressing myself.
I kid you not, you could not come and go, and that man was right there. When he'd see you drive up, he'd run outside, and he'd stand right there.
It's my house, man. I'm the neighbor, man. You see? This is all about neighbor. I actually built like a window there where I could watch him.
We can't come and go. That son of a right here. Right here. Every time.
He was probably getting to me, which he was. He would get to anybody, right? He lived there. He lived to keep an eye on me.
I mean, I was trying to provoke him, and he was provoked, you know.
The man did nothing but egg me. You know, I couldn't come out and mow my lawn. I couldn't do anything. Couldn't wash my van. Couldn't do anything. This man was right there.
Oh, you almost got me. Oh, gee, wait, I'm all wet. Oh, geez, that's terrible. Oh, he got me to
shove it. You can pour water on me, well, I can pour water on him too, right? What did Ed think was going to happen? Did he think I was saying, hey, you know, that's the way it goes? Hell, I was pissed off as hell, man. The guy should have had more sense than to think that everything was going to be happy doodles, you know?
After almost a year of constant harassment, Ed can't take it anymore.
You want to hit me,
huh? No, you damn right I want to hit you. Man, I want to hit you bad.
Well, you can be amazed what I want to do to you.
I don't care what you want to do to me. Why don't you step up here and do it? Why don't you step up here and do it? Because you're a little chicken. You're a big mouth chicken.
No, because I'm not stupid like you are.
Hit me right here. Look, right here you're going. Go ahead, just one time. Don't do it, you know. He kept on doing that. I said, yeah, I'm not stupid. I'm not going to hit you. Come on, thank you. Just one time. And he got so damn mad that even though I didn't hit him, he decides to hit me. Oh, see now, he missed there because I saw it coming. But boy, he sucker punched me the next time, man. Boy, I tell you, I was almost out there, man. Yeah, he even got a good shot there, man. He got what he wanted. And he knocked my glasses off. Did you see that? My glasses flew off, and there I'm in the seventh heaven. Whoa! I didn't know what was happening there for a minute. You could see I staggered. I was dizzy. So I'm looking for my glasses. Oh, man. Phew. I really felt lousy there, man. I tell you.
Ugh. Jim sued Ed for assault and used the video footage as evidence.
It took the jury about 3 hours to decide, hey, this is a frivolous lawsuit and we're not buying it. So they came down and gave him $30 for his damages, and they ordered me $125,000. I don't expect to see any of it. In fact, he's gone, and he's afraid that I might find out where he's at. I'm not in heaven, but I'm real close to in heaven. Jim, if I hadn't been so personally involved with what was going on, I wouldn't have hit you.
Ed, you know what? I know that you weren't at fault. Because I understand mental illness.
He can stay where he is, stay hidden, as far as I'm concerned.
I would have to say I was wrong, you know. It's just ridiculous how hard it is for a man to find a woman in these times.
Coming up.